Hello and welcome to the Kathryn CONVO, where I take you behind the scenes, answer your questions, and give myself liberty to talk about whatever I want. Today I am wet hair, don't care. I am in like full-fledged creation mode, and just it didn't make sense to take an extra half hour today to get ready. So here's me, no makeup, glasses on, this is how it's gonna go. I'm also sitting on top of my roof to keep with this interesting theme of me never being in the same place at a time. So here's where we are, but I am so, guys, this last week has been amazing and so cool. But I think what I'm most excited about is even what's happening more this week. So if you guys have noticed, I'm trying to be strategically loud on social media, and there is just even more awesomeness about to go down that we're getting our systems in place for. And so if you're not already a part of my automator group, I'm gonna be dumping a ton of content in regards to behind the scenes. How am I doing what I'm doing? Why am I doing what I'm doing? So that'll be really pertinent for anybody that has an online business and is kind of looking to systemize it. I think it's gonna be really, really exciting. A ton more stuff being posted on my Instagram, my personal Facebook stuff. We have some amazing YouTube stuff coming out. And also too, in just preparation for the new Traffic Secrets books that's coming out from Russell Brunson, I'm about to do a deep dive into the study of dot-com secrets and expert secrets again, just so that I'm ready for all those different things. And so you'll see I'll be posting in the ClickFunnels group and in other places as well, but if you're ready to get your funnel strategy game on and get really primed and prepped so that when this new material comes out, we're ready to implement like that, you're gonna wanna follow along. So that is some really exciting stuff, but I think what I'm most excited about is Design Hacking Live. I'm so excited. We are finally going to open up ticket sales this Friday, so October 4th. And which, first of all, isn't that weird? It's October. But yes, it's dropping this Friday. We have been working really hard. We have the video just about up and ready, and we got everything put in place. We got the venue in place. We have a lot of the content in place, and now it's just time to get people there and to this event that's absolutely gonna change their life. And I think what I am most excited about, obviously Design Hacking Live, what are we gonna talk about? Obviously design hacking. We're gonna go super deep into the 6-step science that helps you to convert or to build these really high converting pages that look amazing. And so so if you are somebody that's never been inside a CF Design School and you're like, what is this whole thing about? This will be amazing for you. If you're already inside a CF Design School, it's gonna be awesome. We'll take about 30 minutes to get everybody caught up, and then we're gonna go even deeper into how to leverage the skill set of design hacking to take your stuff even to the next level, which means what? You can charge way more for what you're doing, and you yourself can spread your message significantly more. Anyway, so I'm super excited about that. So of course we're talking about design hacking, and then the next day though, what we're gonna talk about is, okay, now that we have this skill set, whether you're applying it to your own business or selling it for other people, like now that we have this thing, how do we explode it? And I think especially if you join the online world, there's like a lot of hype when you're like, oh cool, I made my first few sales, and it's like, wait, how do I scale this thing? How do I make it bigger? How do I make this like automated and continuous? That's what we're gonna talk about the second day, is taking what you've built and spreading it to the masses, whether that's a message you have, or again, your own single product, or whether you are a design hacker and you want to expand what you've done to the outside world. Or maybe let's say you like kill it with ads, or you're a videographer, you have another skill, you have another freelance skill, and you want to know how you combine this with design hacking, and then again, spread that to the masses. So again, like day one is like going deep on what is design hacking, what's the strategy, how do we actually become an expert and master at this craft so that we can 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8x the amount of money that we're charging. And then day number two is how do we expand what it is that we're able to do with that. And so take our systems and processes, because especially as an agency, we know this, right? Like you can only do so many things, like there's only one of you, except if you have the secret weapon of automation and systems, and then you can expand again what you're doing to do even more. So that's what we're gonna talk about day two. So I think this will be a really, really awesome thing. And again, really, really great for anybody that one is already a design hacker, wants to learn how to expand this thing. Two, somebody that's like, I keep hearing about this design hacking thing. I'm not exactly sure what it is, but I feel like I wanna learn it. Great, come on down. Or again, if you are somebody that is just an agency owner and something else and you want to marry your idea with design hacking, I promise you it will increase what you are able to do. And then two, if anybody's looking to expand out what they've already built. So again, day one, we're going deep on design hacking strategy, how to become an expert strategist in terms of that. And then day number two is, okay, now we have these skill sets, these things are set up, how do we explode this thing? How do we lift or break through the ceiling that is sometimes the detriment of business, right? You build this thing, and then you kind of cap out. How do we work through that? And again, that's through specific automations and systems, which we'll talk about. So, and I think it's really exciting. I think as I've been planning this event, I have been to a lot of events myself, and I think some of them have been amazing and some of them have been like, please gouge my eyeballs out, this is terrible. And for a few reasons. One, either the content's terrible. Two, there's like no time to implement. Three, the environment itself is like so awkward. So it's like you're trying to network, but you're like, I don't know, maybe am I dying inside? And you're like, I think maybe I'm internally bleeding because this is so awkward. Like you just don't know what's going on. And so, this whole thing has been curated to make it not only an event where you're able to consume an incredible amount of content, but when you come, we're going to take inventory of where your business is, and then when you leave, we'll take inventory once again. So you are significantly further along. And again, it's not just like, hey, learn. We'll do learn, implement. And so this will be, yes, an event, but a lot more of a masterclass, if that makes sense. Just because, like, I think sometimes we can make things seem harder than they actually are. And I want to show, especially with design hacking and especially with systems, like you can implement them like that. You just need to know the right way to do it. And so that's why I'm like so excited about this thing, is that you won't go home and be like, oh dang, I have like so many things I need to do now. You'll like get home on the plane or in the car or whatever. You'll be like, okay, I'm going back to a whole new business. And so it's going to be really, really fun. And I've just been like trying to be so strategic about how I do this, and I'm actually really grateful. I've been thinking back on like my journey as a teacher, professor, trainer, whatever. So I went on a mission. You guys have heard me say this. I went on a mission from my church to Los Angeles, and then after, when I came home, there's actually this place in Utah. It's called like the Missionary Training Center, where people, before they go out on these year and a half to 24 month missions, they come here to this training center. And so sometimes you learn a language. Sometimes you learn a language there, but mostly you learn like. How do you talk about Jesus and not be weird? Like social skills, right? It's like a little bit intimidating thing to like walk up to somebody and talk about Jesus. So we talk about how to do that. And so when I got back from my mission, I had like such an amazing experience at that missionary training center that I was like, I want to be a teacher there. So I go and I apply, and like, I even know this, like I do not do well in my interviews, and somehow by the grace of God, like I get hired. And oh my gosh, so I'm like, I get hired, and I'm like sitting in this like new teacher meeting, and our boss, who, she was like 3 or 4 years older than us, she was like, hey, listen, like if you're a new teacher, like come set up a meeting with me. I want to go through your interview. Like I took notes on you. I think it'll be like a good starting place to know like kind of where you're at. So, you know, I'm like eager beaver, wanting to be like a good employee. So I like immediately set up a meeting. The next day I go in and she's like, hey, Kathryn, what's up? And I was like, hey, like you asked me to schedule a meeting so we could talk about these certain things. And she's like, oh yeah, for sure. And so she's being super nice, and she pulls up her Evernote, and all of a sudden she like gets to my name. She like clicks on my name and she sees the notes and she goes, oh no. Like, what? And she's like, I forgot about your interview. And I was like, okay. I'm trying to read her emotions. I'm like not really sure what's going on. And I'm like, okay. And she goes, Kathryn, I'm just gonna be honest with you right now. And I'm like, okay. And she goes, you are a terrible teacher. Like really bad. And I was shocked. I literally was like, and I just like, I literally like physically went back. And then my first response was, why did you hire me? I'm like genuinely confused. Like she just trained me to be a teacher. And then she's like, you were terrible. And she's like, I think you have great potential to be amazing. And then as we went through, and I will never forget this, and it's a metric that I try to measure myself against all the time. And she goes, do you want to know the reason why you're such a bad teacher? And I said, yes, I do. And she goes, because the show's all about you. She goes, the whole time you were teaching somebody, you were trying to prove that you knew what you were doing, rather than being concerned about what is it that the other people, like the journey that the other people were going on. And she goes, the show's too much about you. She's like, get out of your own way and actually start taking notice of what is happening in the people that you're teaching. And she goes, then the game changes. So, oh my gosh, so she tells me this. She's like one of the first people in my life to be like so honestly, brutally blunt with me. And it was the best thing that ever happened to me. I go to my car, I cry. I'm like, God, I'm sorry, I suck. I'm like, but I just felt like that. I was just like, I have to learn how to do this better. So I truly was like the worst. And it was amazing. And I ended up working there for a little bit over 2 years. And by the end, like whenever missionaries come through, so I ended up teaching thousands and thousands of these missionaries that came through. And they rank all the teachers and what it is. And by the end, I was so grateful. I was actually ranked the number one teacher amongst 350 plus teachers there. And I think it was because, and I like owe this all to this woman who just like absolutely tore me to bits. It was amazing, but it was awesome. And I think because I'd just been like so absolutely like roasted that first time. It was amazing. So I just had this woman in my class all the time. I asked for brutal feedback and I was just like, tell me what it is. And I just was committed to not be offended by what she had to say and be more committed to getting better. And again, it was one of the best things that's ever happened to me. And I think it's carried over a lot into how I teach and train today. And so for me, like as I'm planning this event, and granted, like it's always a learning process, but like as I'm like building up all these courses and different things like CF Design School, it's like, okay, cool. Like, yes, of course we're gonna have a graduation because the show is about them and it should be about them. Like they're the ones doing the work, they're the ones getting the results. And so the same thing goes with Design Hacking Live. Like I'm being serious, like we're gonna take an inventory of where you start and an inventory of where you are at the end because I'm so committed to making sure that the show is about you, right? Like, I mean, cool, it'd be great if I got like a ton of people there and they all like thought it was a great event and Kathryn's so smart, but like who cares if nobody ever actually does anything about it, right? And so this whole event is being curated toward creating tangible evidences around being able to see the progression in your business from where you are to where it is when you leave 2 days later. So anyway, it's gonna be in Salt Lake City. We booked the venue. It's freaking rad. Tickets go on sale on Friday. You'll see it there. If you want to know, if you wanna like be on the list beforehand, it's like Design Hacking Live. You'll see there's like a, you can get on like a pre-list or whatever so you can know when we send it out. But early bird pricing will be available for a little bit. That's what happens October 4th. But it's gonna be so cool. Again, day one, we're going deep into design hacking. Day two is, now that you know design hacking, how do you scale this thing to really make it significant and take over the world. So that's what I'm doing for the next few days, is building out a dope funnel for that. And I'm really excited about it. So just know, if you ever have feedback for me, I would love to take it. Sure, great. And I'm really grateful, honestly, for people that give me feedback. It's helpful. In fact, actually the other day, my parents, which, and again, here's the thing. I think there's like a balance to taking feedback. It's like, if you're a stranger on the internet who's just rude, like, I don't care about you. But I think that there are so many people that I'm grateful for that I trust in my life, that they tell me things and I like listen. Like, yes, 2.5 days ago, right? Like my parents, I love them so much. They're like, Kathryn, we need to talk to you about your videos online. I'm like, okay. And they're like, they're really good, but you mumble, you talk too fast, and your intonation goes down. Like you kind of drop off at the end of your sentences. And so I was like, okay, wait, show me. So we did. And I was so grateful for them. I was like, you guys are right. But I think I just get so excited. So I talk a million miles a minute and I'm just like, design hacking, blah, blah, blah. They're like, sweetie, you got to slow down a little bit. So anyway, what I'm trying to say is I'm so grateful for amazing people in my life, like the woman that hired me, my parents, like my coaches, and even my students who have been able to give me awesome feedback so that we can continue to grow this better and better. And again, that's what we'll be doing at Design Hacking Live, is like this whole thing has been curated based off what people are saying that they're needing. And again, day one, deep into design hacking. Day two, deep into systems to scale that design hacking skill. And I'm so excited. It's gonna be so awesome. So coming out Friday, that's when the early bird price is gonna be available. The funnel's being built this week. The promo video for it is so cool. It's coming out this Friday, and mostly that's it for me. Also, I'm sitting on my roof again. I found this, look at that ball. I'm sure that has been there for over 10 years. Like, how long has that been there? Mom, dad, I don't know. But anyway, you guys are amazing. I'll see you, of course, all across the interwebs the rest of this week. Be looking for Friday, Design Hacking Live. It's happening in Salt Lake City, March 27th, 28th, a Friday and a Saturday. And it's gonna be unlike any event you've ever been to. which is awesome. So anyway, I'll see you guys in the video a little bit later. Talk to you later. Thanks for being so great. Care about you. Bye.